stages of this. So I was kind of up to date with everything and knowing that we were getting closer and closer. A little, you know, knickknacks that we wanted to get, they wanted to get. So just negotiating that part. But it got real. It was like, we're there. You know, we're happy. We're never satisfied, but we're very happy with what we have in front of us.
It's 76 degrees at 12 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Now, get ready to spend the next 2 hours with our three sports-loving ladies. Mia O'Brien, Lauren Brooks, and Taylor Dahl.
This is Helmets and Heels
on 1010XL, switched on by First Coast Lighting and Fans. Upscale lighting, fans, and home decor. Show me what you got,
lady. Taylor is on assignment at the moment. She will hopefully join us in a little bit. But I think the switched on, Mia, has extra significance today during this weather.
We may need First Coast Lighting. hopefully we don't, because I think all of the problems from this morning, shout out to the drill and Jaguars today and the wonderful folks at JEA, who I'm assuming were able to turn the power back on. There was a tree that went down. So if you're just turning on the Superstation, you tried to listen this morning, I know like I did, and looking around like, is my car messed up? And then I got home, I tried the app. The app wasn't working. I tried my computer, and I was like, is this me? Am I being punked? Is this April Fool's Day 10 days later? But yes, there was a tree that fell down, knocked out part of our power grid. All is well, and I believe we are also, for the first time today since the drill at approximately 9:15, Lauren, streaming on our live stream as well. RJ, hopefully we got that up and running, and we do. And
beautiful.
So if you want to, if you're part of our loyal YouTube chat line, Heligan following, which I know there's plenty of you out there. You guys have been so active in the first 8 shows history of this iteration of Helmets and Heels. So keep it coming, and especially as we – oh, and there it is. Yep, my audio on my computer isn't turned up, but hey, at least the audio on the live stream is working. Especially the chat line I know will be lighting up there and on the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures as we discuss 24 hours later, Lauren, Josh Allen officially inked for 5 more years with the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Yeah, by the way, I think it's pretty impressive with technology that you can still broadcast over the airwaves even if the power does go out. Like, the lights may not be on, but you can still have a signal.
Oh,
yeah. It's pretty impressive.
Yes.
But yes.
Well, that was honestly, like, it was funny. Like, when I was told exactly what happened, like, all the scenarios keep running through my mind. And I'm like, okay, well, in theory, we could just straight live stream. And I'm like, oh, we won't have commercials, which, like, isn't great, but at least we'll have content. And I was, like, trying to, like, run through in my brain. And then ultimately I was like, well, if we have literally no power to the refrigerator, I'm not really sure. I'm not really sure what else I can do outside of here's my phone. Like, let's try to do that or StreamYard or something.
Well, like you said, we're back up and running. So, yes, yesterday Josh Allen, after inking his deal, 5 years, $150 million, with 88 of that guaranteed, he did meet with the media and started by thanking everyone for showing up on such short notice. Mia, you've obviously dealt with Josh Allen for many years now. I've dealt with Josh Allen for many years now. One of my favorite moments is back during COVID when we still had the virtual media availability. And at the end of every single time he met with the media, he would literally go through and read each person's name that was on the screen. And there was at one point in time, my camera, I had finally turned it off because we were done, but my name was still up there. And he's like, Lauren, is Lauren there? And Amanda Holt from Jags PR is like, yes, she's there. And he's like, hey, Lauren. So I had to turn my camera back on. Like, hey, Josh, it's okay. You can sign off now. But he has always been, obviously, a media darling, but also a really, really good football player. And I think Trent Baalke, like we talked about yesterday, he may not have arrived at the deal the way everyone would have liked, but the fact that Josh Allen is a key piece of this team and hopefully a Super Bowl winning team, as he mentioned yesterday, that is important for this city.
Yes, and to just reiterate what I said yesterday, I think for the Trent Baalke side of this, this was necessary to put your money where your mouth is. If you're going to say that the Jaguars are going to develop and re-sign their own, you had to do it for a guy who has done everything right, who has the single season record for sacks in franchise history. He, as he noted yesterday, is 10 sacks away from the all-time franchise record.
He better get there.
You literally can't let that guy walk out the door.
Yeah. And nor was he ever going to. That's the thing. That's why Trent Baalke said Josh will be a Jaguar. We just didn't know at the time that Josh didn't know that.
RJ, do you have that soundbite hand though? No. You're thinking the soundbite we're gonna play. I want you to. Oh, there we go. He's ready. I wanted to play it yesterday, just as like almost like a saucy nug.
Yeah.
I think we need to add it to the Helmets and Heels database because it's just. Whenever we reference, Josh will be a Jaguar. RJ, what do we play? Oh, he's still loading it. All right, the technology.
He's got work to do.
This technology we're still working on. That's
yeah,
okay.
But we are going to play a soundbite from Josh Allen yesterday. Not all of them, but one in particular that I really like. And it's when Josh Allen was asked about the rest of the defensive front. And I really liked one thing he said about Eric Armstead. You really liked one thing he said about his position availability. So let's hear that.
Eric Armstead.
Now we got Eric Armstead. Sorry about that. I thought RJ had something else ready. Again, we're still getting our feet under us. The power is back on. Go ahead, RJ. Ignore me.
Eric Armstead, who I'm in awe about. I'm excited for him. He's going to be a great asset to this team. Can't wait to get to work with him. Can't wait to rush with him and against him to get to the quarterback. And it's going to push me to have that sense of urgency. And I'm excited for that.
Yeah, and I think the reason that I really like that cut is about Eric Armstead when Josh said, I'm in awe of him. You don't usually get a player who is Josh Allen's caliber, who is one of the best in the league the last 2 years at getting after the quarterback. And we all know how important that is if you're trying to win football games. You don't usually have a guy like that say that about another player. And so for Josh to be, as he said multiple times yesterday, humble and emotional, but for him to say that about Eric, I don't know if this city is as excited yet, Mia, as they should be for Eric Armstead and how much he's going to bring to that defensive front.
Yeah, Josh will be a Jaguar.
There it is. Hey, listen.
This is what Mia's been waiting for 24 hours.
Yes, we're still waiting for the bells and whistles. Look, this show is a work in progress, and we're A-OK with that. But yes, I think that what's so fascinating is to pair a couple things together. I liked how when we had, which is crazy to think it was a week ago today, we had Foye Aluikin in studio. Thankfully,
yes.
The power was working that day. I did think about that as well this morning. But Foye stressed how he didn't want to be Instagram messaging Eric Armstead. He wanted to meet him for the first time. And I think, Josh has a similar way about him. He does things the right way. He wants to meet people where they are. I haven't met Eric Armstead yet, but we get that vibe. And I'm not trying to say that the Jaguars are first team all human beings, and therefore that's going to translate to first team all defense, first team all offense, whatever you want to say.
Right.
But I think that there's the personalities are very similar on this team, and I think that bodes well as you're trying to bring that defense together. Still, I understand it's year three of Doug Peterson, and you're still bringing in pieces from the outside as you're trying to bring all those pieces together and find some cohesiveness.
It's funny, Mia. For a long time, this fan base was sick and tired of the quote-unquote choir boys being drafted or being brought in as free agents because they thought that you can't be both a good person and a good football player. Because other GMs had a way of selecting players based off of their character, maybe more so than their on-field performance. Now, I think ever since Calais Campbell arrived to Jacksonville, everybody has kind of quieted down about that because they realize that you can be a Walter Payton Man of the Year award winner and you can be a guy who opposing quarterbacks are terrified to face.
Right, and I think that what's so unfortunate is Calais Campbell won the Walter Payton Man of the Year award and then was dealt a month later. And then Dave Caldwell went out and drafted 12 choir boys, for lack of a better term, or at least that's what people were saying back then. But I do think because Trent Baalke arrived in the building shortly before the Calais Campbell trade, I do think the two things do kind of coincide in terms of getting good people in the building and the effort to do that. And if you want to attribute it to the aftermath of Jalen Ramsey's departure,
right.
The aftermath of Yannick Ngakoue fighting with the owner's son online, go ahead, feel free. And I know many of you driving around right now are saying, why are they blabbering on about character? We just want to win football games. Well, it just so happens, I'd like to think these are pretty high character guys that are also going to win you football games. And that is something this franchise hasn't had outside of Calais Campbell in quite some time.
Yeah, and that's the thing is everyone being focused on winning the division to start and then, of course, going farther in the postseason than they did 2 years ago. That is a goal that I think is going to be at the forefront of almost every conversation that we have with players throughout the next few months leading up to the season and throughout the season because they now realize some of them had only known losing, right? Mm-hmm. Unless they were here in 2017, and that's very few and far between. Cam Robinson, Tyler Shatley, Dwan Smoot, maybe?
Which those last two aren't on the roster right now.
So, yeah. There's those guys who experienced one season of winning, and then everybody who came after that only knows the losing. And then all of a sudden, there was the 1 year in the playoffs. And so I think some of them might have thought, okay, that's going to be easy now that Doug Peterson's our head coach. We'll be in the playoffs every year. He's taken the Eagles to the playoffs multiple times, won the Super Bowl. And then last year was a complete and total wake-up call. Even their head coach said, I think some of them were reading their press clippings, right? Mm-hmm. So now I think they are going to be absolutely fueled by, we know now most of them know what it takes to make the postseason from two seasons ago, and they know exactly where they fell off the cliff last season.
RJ, if you could get ready, clip number 7 from yesterday's press conference, because I think we can tie a couple other things together. To your point, Lauren, that's the reason Mitch Morse was brought in. That's the reason Eric Armstead was brought in, because Doug Peterson admitted he felt like there weren't enough guys in that locker room that had multiple years of postseason experience under their belt. It was just that one euphoric run in 2022 for the bulk of the roster, and thus they didn't know how to handle success and adversity when it struck 1 year later.
And by the way, Gabe Davis and Devin Duvernay, too.
Yes, who have both played in multiple postseasons, and so it's important to note, basically, and Darnell Savage with the Packers.
Yes.
I
forget that they actually went to the postseason.
And Ronald Darby won a Super Bowl. Like, also every true. Guy they brought in has been to the postseason multiple times over. And I think that the thought is that that energy will seep into guys who have already been there once before, are emerging leaders or are leaders like Josh Allen, and in turn can inspire that next group akin to one Trayvon Walker.
Trayvon called me and he said he had a day off, but he wanted to go work out, you know, because that motivated him. Like, seeing what I got motivated him. So it's like, you know, to have a guy like Trayvon keep getting better and better and better each year, it's only going to make me want to have to get better, because I got to be the best player on his team. So I'm always competing with him. He knows that.
I got to be the best player on this team. And that's someone who knows that, hey, if I'm going to be paid this much money, again, I need to put my money where my mouth is. And so I think that's where the train of thought is trending in the right direction. And, of course, great to hear that Trayvon was inspired by, hey, if Josh got the bag, now I have to start working so I get the bag as well. The other part of the conversation regarding Eric Armstead and Ryan Nielsen and the new defense that I want to get into, we will talk about the situation regarding Josh and OTAs, although I don't think, honestly.
It's not a situation.
It's not a situation. OTAs are voluntary. As John Shipley noted on Jaguars Today, he didn't go last year and he had the best year of his career. Like, if you're the Jags, you're telling him, please go back to Arizona. Do whatever you did last year, because we need that again. And, of course, he needs it to hit certain incentives, as the contract specifics noted when Mike Florio of Pro Football Talk released that 2 days ago, or yesterday, I should say. It's all blending together. But the point I want to make is regarding a quote that kind of got, I don't even know if it's in the bite, RJ. And so it'll in the clip that Gibby put together, it would be number 9 in theory. But I'm very curious if it even makes the cut, because it was almost like kind of snuck in there. I was the only reporter at the press conference who tweeted it out. And then as we're all sitting there kind of debriefing after Josh had left, somebody said, hey, did you hear what he said about our best player needs to be playing, you know, being able to slide inside?
First and foremost, you got to see how the lineup is going to be. I think that's important. You know, you brought him here to play a lot. You just re-signed me to play a lot. Trayvon just come off a 10-sack season, who's only progressing. We have Roy, we have Deham, we have Adam. We just signed Jeremiah back. So you see the tools and the pieces that we have.
So, yeah, didn't even get to it. Didn't even get to it. So I will continue.
That's on purpose for people who don't understand radio
right.
world. You don't want your sound bites to be anywhere past about like 20 to 30 seconds, because they'd take too long.
But that's literally like how this got snuck in. So after he says how he signed Jeremiah Ledbetter back, and this, that, and the other, he says, you see the tools and the pieces that we have. And so it's just, first of all, how are we going to rotate that? How are we going to do that? What are we asking everybody to do? Then going out there, once we have that front of, this is where what we're looking at. I know Coach Nielsen is a defensive line guy. If you want your best player to rotate inside, I've shown that I can play 3-tech on a guard. Everybody is good in the National Football League, but you know what I mean? Trayvon can go inside. Eric can go inside and outside. Roy has some outside stuff. So we can rotate and see where everybody best fits.
I think that Ryan Nielsen, like I said yesterday, somewhere in Jacksonville, he's smiling because he knows he has his one of his key pieces locked up now for several more years, and five more years at least. But I think, Mia, people get so locked into, well, the Jaguars can't draft an edge rusher at 17 because that person's not going to start. That's a very, and I think like that sometimes too, that's a very linear way of thinking. But there are so many different ways that you can go about it and moving those pieces around. So, yeah, I think this defensive front will be, what, maybe three times better than it was a year ago?
The hope is, yes.
That's what looking at the pieces from a season ago with Devon Hamilton struggling with the illness and having to miss so many games, with the way Foley Fatakasi played, Roy Robertson Harris was fine.
Yeah.
Not great, terrible.
He wasn't what he was the last six games of 2022.
Right, and so now you add Arik Armstead, and you have Devon Hamilton, you assume fully healthy and more motivated, I would guess, Roy Robertson Harris, because he wants to get back to the postseason too. I think they're going to be a lot better than the defensive front we saw a year ago. And the question is, how many more sacks, of course, does that lead to? And like Taylor always mentions, quarterback pressures as well. If you're getting a lot of quarterback pressures, those are eventually going to lead to sacks as well. Because you have to have a higher production if you want to be one of the best teams in the NFL.
And it's also important to note with, you know, I know Demetrius Harvey is now kind of backed off of, he had Jared Verse in this week, his mock draft this week. I had him 2 weeks ago. Mia's mock draft 1.0, still available on 1010XL.com. I think it's important to note with all the discussion surrounding Ryan Nielsen, he needs a press man corner. The coverage in the back end needs to be sound. Well, the coverage in the back end, yes, you want it to be top tier, but if you're getting pressure up front, then you afford your secondary a couple seconds of leeway. Because if you're getting to the quarterback in 4 seconds, 5 seconds, then they don't have to cover that long. And so that's where it's a yin and a yang, and it has to go hand in hand. And that's why, to the text line's point, thank you to 368 for this, with the extra $13 million that the Jaguars will now reportedly save, according to the terms of Josh Allen's contract, because he won't play on the tag, would they make any moves? We can save the Brandon Ayuk conversation for another day. I haven't heard anything. Haven't heard any moves of T. Higgins. I've seen plenty of you tweeting at me about that. I have heard nothing about that in 3 weeks. Where I look at that $13 million and I say I know what the plan is, it's for that second or third, I guess, wave of free agency after the NFL draft. That is for the Bud Duprees of the world. That is for, dare I say, and again, He met with the Jaguars last year. I know he's coming off an injury. I don't know this year. Just throwing the name out there, Yannick Ngakoue. That wave of guys, if the Jaguars can't get an edge in the NFL draft, if they don't go edge in the first round, it's very clear to me, and hearing Josh's comments about the rotation and needing more guys and trying to keep guys fresh and keep the opposition on its heels by putting guys in multiple positions, that's where it says to me they are not done with that room. Do not think for a second they are done with that room. And so whether it is, hey, Jared Verse presents himself at 17, or you look up at 96 and you need a corner still, or hopefully they've addressed it before then, but if they still need a corner because they go up for a wide receiver, let's say, which may or may not be Mia's mock draft 3.0, and so they have to draft the corner at 96. Now you get to 114. The depth isn't there in that edge class, but you know you have two bona fide starters at the wide receiver and corner position that you come away with, so you say, you know what, okay, we'll go call Bud Dupree. We had him on speed dial all along.
And that is going to be fun to watch, as is the NFL draft, which comes up in just a few weeks from now. It'll be 2 weeks from today, right?
Man,
yeah, time
is
flying by. So, yeah, you can check out more of Mia's mock drafts on 1010XL.com. But we are going to continue our countdown to the NFL draft. Coming up next, the hated Titans. We don't hate this guy. We just hate the Titans. Blaine Bishop will join us and predict who he thinks the Titans will be targeting with their selection. You are listening to Helmets and Heels on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Girls just want to talk football.
Helmets and Heels.
From the First Coast Lighting Studios at 1010XL.
Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. Here we go again with Rory McIlroy in the career Grand Slam. McIlroy trying to become the sixth player to win all four majors.
I've got all the tools to do well this week. But again, to bring those tools out, I think one of the most important things is to enjoy it and smell the, I guess, not the roses, the azaleas along the way.
Oh, good job catching yourself. McIlroy has actually missed the cut here two of the last 3 years, but he did finish solo second in 2022. And McIlroy is grouped with the player who won that year, Scottie Scheffler, along with Xander Schauffele. They tee off next hour. Rory visited the legendary swing coach Butch Harmon in Las Vegas recently, and he tied for third in San Antonio last week. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger. For the ones who get it done.
Want to keep your gas-powered engines running like new? Stables' proprietary formulas are proven by third-party testing to outperform the competition in keeping fuel fresh, preventing corrosion, and cleaning the entire fuel system. With Stable, you can have confidence you are doing the right thing for your engine's long-term health. Just pour into your gas can or fuel tank, then top off with fresh fuel. At every fill-up or when you store, start with Stable. Available where fuel additives are sold.
First round of the Masters delayed 2.5 hours by rain. Now the sun is starting to peek through the clouds, and with gusts of 30 miles an hour out of the south. Let's check the leaderboard, sponsored by Grainger. With supplies and solutions for every industry, Grainger has the right product for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. A blistering start for Bryson DeChambeau. He has birdied the first three holes to move to 3 under par. DeChambeau, one of the 13 players from LIV Golf in the field this year. South African Eric Van Rooyen is 2 under through 7. Ryan Fox from New Zealand is 2 under after 2 holes. Danny Willett bogeys the 5th to move to 1 under par with Christo Lamprecht, Torbjörn Olesen, Jasper Stubbs, and Ben Ahn. 2017 Masters champ Sergio Garcia either looks like he lost a bet payoff, or maybe it's the best look ever at Augusta. Lime green shirt with highlighter yellow pants. Garcia with a par at 1, and it'll be a late start for Tiger Woods, teeing off at 3:54 Eastern. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
Oh boy, the Masters is here, Tiger is in the field, and the LIV guys are back at the majors again. Mia here, and if you haven't signed up for MyBookie, you need to sign up this week. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, live betting too. I'm telling you, if you haven't signed up yet for MyBookie, do it for Masters Week. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that. Make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you can still live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up to 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. This is one of the most fun betting weeks of the year, and you can hit winners for long odds. Promo code 1010XL. Bet with MyBookie.
Lauren Brooks here from Mayport C&C Fisheries. Growing up at the beach, I know good shrimp and oysters when I see them. They're local and they're fresh. That's why Mayport C&C Fisheries is my go-to for both. They have local shrimp in stock 7 days a week. Eat like a local at Mayport C&C Fisheries.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket, with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit ua234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
1010XL's running game takes a giant step forward.
Well, Fred Taylor is the whole package.
Fred Taylor joins Dan and Jeff on the Trill. Monday Morning Running Back with Fred Taylor is fueled by Epstein and Robbins and B&B Fuel and Lubricants.
Divorce, menonly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to divorcemenonly.com. Divorcemenonly.com. Offices Jacksonville.
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time, in fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing, and it's serious, and it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th, bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena.
Guns and Hoses.
After consulting with several orthopedic specialists about my constant knee pain, I chose Southeast Orthopedic Specialist and Dr. Chris Swanson to handle my surgery. Their professionalism let me know this team was the one for me. The surgery was very successful, and if I ever have a future knee, I'll continue to trust Southeast Orthopedic Specialists to take care of me.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Breaking news, Jacksonville. Play It Again Sports is back. We are proud to be opening a brand new store on Merrill Road, but we need your help. We are currently stocking up and we need your gently used sports and fitness equipment. Play It Again Sports offers cash on the spot for all your used gear. We buy baseball, softball, football, hockey, lacrosse, golf, water sports. You name it, we buy it. Turn that gear into cash at Play It Again Sports Jacksonville on Merrill Road near 295 in the Merrill Station Shopping Plaza.
When you hear Florida Gators baseball on 1010XL, it's brought to you by Renewal by Anderson, the official window and door replacement partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. And Farrah and Farrah, the official personal injury law firm of the Jaguars.
Rick Ballew for Carlson Dental. You know, I've been telling you this for quite some time because it's true. I hate going to the dentist, or at least I used to hate going to the dentist. I had total anxiety. And then I tried sedation, light sedation for cleaning and deep sedation as well for cavities and root canals. Folks, it's an incredible experience. So don't be nervous. Don't be scared. Go to CarlsonDentalGroup.com. That's CarlsonDentalGroup.com for all of your dental needs.
American Electrical, Northeast Florida's highest rated electricians, is hiring, and they're looking for people to train for careers. It's not just job training. They're giving you a license that no one can take away from you, training you for jobs that are always in demand and will offer you a peace of mind financially and for the future. Once you know a trade, you'll always be employable. All the details are at American-Electrical.com, and with their American Electrical Academy, if you're selected, you'll learn the electrical trade absolutely free of charge. American Electrical Contractors, powered by professionalism.
1010XL is presented by Farrah and Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
Ready? In 3, 2, 1.
The countdown to the draft is on.
I hope you're ready.
Who'll be off the board when the Jaguars pick? Let's find out.
You better believe in Chad.
The last time I spoke with this next individual and his 104.5 contemporaries, 104.5 The Zone, of course, up in Nashville, Blaine Bishop and company told me, you know, it's either going to be Derrick Henry's swan song in this 2023 finale or the Jaguars will win by 30. As we all know, it was the former. There were also rumblings in the press conference that day of Mike Vrabel's departure, which has since come to pass. Blaine Bishop joining us now on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline. Man, oh, man, has a lot happened in the last 4 months, my friend.
Oh, man, time flies, man, with the NFL. So it's been a unique time, but the NFL dominates even in the off season, and it's always fun and fun and new excitement to new coaching staff and with the Titans and new players getting signed. So it's the dawn of a new era there in Tennessee with the Titans.
Yes. Before we ask you where you believe Brian Callahan and company may be leaning with that 7th overall pick, his first as the head coach of the Titans, Blaine, first and foremost, how are you? Welcome back into 1010XL and making your maiden voyage on Helmets and Heels. And I also have to start big picture with Brian Callahan, with the decision to part ways with Mike Vrabel. Big picture, how have you seen this franchise change over the last 4 months with a new head coach?
Well, I'm going to address it like this. I thought Mike Vrabel was a good coach. But I had been saying, and I was the only person here in the state of Tennessee saying, Mike Vrabel was on the hot seat. And it was because I was operating. He was not operating in collaboration with the new GM. There were leaks of that he wasn't qualified, the GM, which came had to come from Vrabel, and that he should have been an assistant and not a GM. And that's during our season. That all kind of transpired when he got inducted into the New England Hall of Fame there. And all that noise from New England came about. Then, oh, he's going to be the next coach there. And then they weren't winning. And then he was a major cog in, if not all the cog in, making all the decisions last year. And the Dillard signing was all him. And once I found that out, I thought he was on the hot seat. Because Dillard signing wrecked the entire offensive line. If he was even competent enough to be the starter and do a halfway decent job, the Titans would have been a little bit, okay, Vrabel is a good, solid, average coach in my mind. So I said that, and everybody thought I was crazy. Like Vrabel, I don't take things personal. I want the Titans to win. That's what I do take personal. And I want them to win a Super Bowl. And I want to say I was, you know, part of that. In a different way than as a player. So I thought his treatment of players, he had favorites. You don't ever show your hand as favorites. We are all parents, and you do not let the kids know which one is your favorite. Well, he did, and he does. And so that continued. He would pull players. This is not college. So I said, I think he'll be a great college coach. He would pull a player for getting beat for a touchdown. I don't care how many reps we do that. Now you start messing with the mental psyche of the actual player. You don't have a five-star sitting on the bench. There's a reason why the guy's the backup. You got another okay player who's probably on minimum salary as an NFL player. He did it routinely, but he didn't do it to the guys that he liked. So these were things I felt like could divide the locker room. That's just an example. And so as time went on, I felt like his words got stale with the players. And eventually it did. And the organization, in my mind, made the absolute right decision. It's the dawn of a new era, and this is not the time I played in 1999 and 2000 with one left, one right, with a phenomenal player with Derrick Henry. But that's not the only way you can skin a cat. So when you get in games where you get behind, you have no shot of winning the game. This now is a passing league, and you can use the pass to set up the run, or you can use the sharp passing game when you don't have competent enough. When I say competent, I'm like athletic enough to hold up on the front offensive line. You still don't have to run the football. So it was just like running into darkness. And my evaluation of the team continued, and I thought Amy Adams Strunk did a superb job in her decision and processing and hired someone I hope that can be, don't know much about Callahan, be a good coach and coaching staff. They are right now giving us so much information behind the scenes that we have never had, I don't think, with any coach that's ever coached the Tennessee Titans since I left. So it's been refreshing, to say the least, and I don't think anyone's intimidated asking questions at a presser. I think they feel, wow, this is different. We haven't seen this. So hopefully that translates into some players. But they're in a rebuild mode. So, you know, hopefully this season they'll be in a lot of games and, you know, fighting maybe at the end for a playoff spot. But after 1 year and then I think next year, then they'll be in the right spot with the collaboration of all the people in the front office with the head coach as well as the coaching staff. It was do it my way or the highway with Vrabel.
Blaine, that's good insight because from our perspective here in Jacksonville, we all thought Vrabel was a really good coach, but obviously
he is.
Yeah, but didn't know kind of some of those ins and outs that you were just referring to. All right, we of course have to ask you about Calvin Ridley. Will Levis now gets to throw to DeAndre Hopkins and Ridley. When that contract came out, what did you think?
I was stunned. I didn't even know they were even talking to Calvin Ridley. Had no clue. No one did. Not at all. that was on the wraps. And then it came to fruition for us, sitting in the media, is that he contacted Amos Strunk and said, I think they made an adjustment. I think they couldn't get a player they thought they wanted, and probably at a different position. And they had an allotment of money, and they said, let's go for it. And someone on the staff, Holtz, had a relationship with Ridley, probably gave them great insight of who he was, and not just on the field. And it's all about people and people skills and relationships. And I think that put them over the top, and they were going to do what they could to get a playmaker and see if Will Levis can be a really good quarterback in the National Football League.
Yeah, Blaine, which I think another offensive move, which the big one being Derrick Henry leaving but being replaced by Tony Pollard, who I personally am a big fan of Pollard. So it's one of those things where you've noticed him the last couple years really start to ramp up his play on the football field. So what were the feelings with that, the goodbye to Derrick but the hello to Tony?
Well, it was a great sayonara for Henry. He's, you know, great player, great person, great human being, all those things. And it's unfortunate. You know, I'm a fan of the game as well, an evaluator. But it was time to turn the page. And I had no idea they were going to go for turn five. Finally, they signed Pollard first. Mm-hmm. So that was kind of, whoa, okay. So I think they were trying to be intentional there, if I was guessing, because they wanted the fans to, I guess, move on from Henry, who was a legendary player and probably a Hall of Fame player. So that's always tough from a fan perspective, because you're also trying to get fans in the stands, and this is a business. Mm-hmm. So I thought that was interesting, but it shows you where they were going. They wanted multifaceted type running backs. So they have Spears there from Tulane last year, who's kind of a little dynamo who can do a little bit of everything really well in between the tackles. So they got two of those guys now. That's kind of how I view it, just in case one gets banged up because they are on a smaller side. It's going to be an offensive-driven, you know, team. So, yeah, I'm excited. Explosive players that are dynamic in open space. I think I can't recall the last player we had someone like that on our team, let alone Ridley, too, with his speed.
Blaine Bishop is our guest, the former Tennessee Titan, four-time Pro Bowler, two-time All-Pro, turned co-host of the Blaine and Mickey Show, which you get 1 to 3 p.m. Central Time, 2 to 4 Eastern on 104.5 The Zone. Blaine, we've arrived at that fun part of this interview. With the 7th overall pick in the 2024 NFL Draft, Blaine Bishop believes that the Tennessee Titans are leaning towards selecting...
That's always conflicting how you put that. Blaine Bishop, me, or do I think what the team will do?
You can give us both. Leaning. We will take both. We would love to hear where the team is leaning, but we also, hey, you're a former Titan. You bleed that other type of blue color that we won't talk about here in Jacksonville.
Of course.
Where do you feel the team is leaning versus where you would go?
Well, I have to say this, the Titans still haven't addressed tackle, so you would assume that it will be the first tackle that's available when they pick. Now, who that will be, I have no idea. I'm not evaluating drafts. All this good. They could divert and go in a different direction because actually it's a deep draft at offensive line, at offensive tackle, and may be able to get another position with that pick. Now, so I think they're going to go offensive tackle. But if they don't, I don't know how they've graded the players. If they can't get the top two tackles for whatever reason, so they're not available, I think they will adjust and go either wide receiver or defensive edge rusher.
Okay.
Which a lot of people here will be shocked. But I think if you can get the number one pass rusher and you still only have a Landry and Arden Key, and who's more of a rotational player when he's effective, in my opinion, that's kind of where I think they will go. Naturally, the fans here want Brock Bowers with that pick at 7. I don't know what the heck they're doing there, but Brock Bowers can't, as much as I love him as a player, he'd be nullified by staying and blocking a lot for Will Levis, helping him out. So, I think they got to go tackle or edge if I was making a guess.
Yes, after, as you noted, the misstep by Mike Vrabel to bring in a free agent, can the Titans finally fortify the turnstile they've had on the edge to go along on that left side with Peter Skoronski? Blaine Bishop of 104.5 The Zone, thank you so much for joining us on Helmets and Heels and, of course, on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline, my friend.
Anytime, ladies.
There he goes. And again, Blaine and Mickey, 1 to 3 Central Time. If you ever find yourself up in Nashville or looking for insight on those Titans, they do a pretty darn good job at 104.5 The Zone. I feel like as we've counted down to 17, Lauren and Taylor, a lot of the stations and media conglomerates that when Taylor and I set out to develop the 1010XL multimedia department, we looked at them and we were like, oh, they're doing it right. Mm-hmm. And as much as we will never give the Tennessee Titans credits for anything, 104.5 The Zone, very good media conglomerate.
There you have it. All right. We have two. By the way, hello, Taylor.
Hello. I'm here.
I was going to say, we have to say hello to Taylor. Taylor made it. But also, we have to recap our NFL draft countdown. We will do that when we return on 1010XL on 92.5 FM.
Sports-loving ladies.
Helmets and heels.
From the First Coast Lighting Studios at 1010XL.
May I have your attention, please?
Get ready for 1010XL's new primetime lineup. Start the day with Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser. Dempsey and Fat Tony take you to noon. It's the ladies of Helmets and Heels until 2. XL primetime follows at 4. Franchi and Carline drive you home. Then Baloo and Hacker take you into the night.
It's showtime!
Gator fans, get ready. The Orange and Blue game is back on Saturday, April 13th at 1 p.m. in the Swamp, and entry is free. This year, Florida Victorious is proud to sponsor the game, and we have tons of new excitement in store for you, like our player meet and greet and autograph session after the game on Steve Spurrier Field. As a member of Florida Victorious, you can visit with players on the team, including Mertz and Lagway. Don't miss out on FanFest, which begins at 10 a.m. on the North Lawn. Visit the Florida Victorious tent to learn more about the team and membership benefits, and also meet Gator student athletes. Join us for the chance to win a brand new Chevy Silverado on the field. Brought to you by Southern Chevy Dealers and Florida Victorious. Learn more about Florida Victorious and become a member at FloridaVictorious.com. FloridaVictorious.com. And help us make Florida victorious.
Life has its share of challenges, and when it puts you to the test, make sure you reach out to Rebound Rehabilitation to give you the quickest path back to full health and confidence. Rebound Rehab, specializing in helping patients overcome back pain and sciatica, arthritis, and fibromyalgia, just to name a few. Rebound Rehab, locations covering the entire First Coast, getting you back in control with a pain-free life. Sports injury, workplace injury, whatever it might be, you can rebound. Log on to reboundrehab.com for more info.
Whether you're in need of a simple AC repair or it's time to upgrade your HVAC system, Duck Duck Air Conditioning is here to help. Give us a call today to schedule an estimate, 904-862-6769, or online at duckduckac.com.
The Jacksonville Icemen are playoff bound.
There are three regular season home games left.
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. The Icemen fight for a division title this weekend, starting Friday against the Savannah Ghost Pirates.
The first 1,000 fans get a Fang the Mascot bobblehead.
Then Saturday at 7 and Sunday at 3, it's the Atlanta Gladiators. Get tickets at Ticketmaster, JacksonvilleIcemen.com, or call 904-602-PUCK. Icemen hockey is hashtag fire within.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 11, 1965, Jack Nicklaus wins the second of his six Masters titles in Augusta, beating Gary Player and Arnold Palmer by a record 9 strokes.
All right, guys, be a true grill master with the Sausage Dudes sausage and upgrade that cookout. The Sausage Dudes are guys from Jacksonville who use their family recipes to make better sausage with the best cuts of pork, carefully sourced spices, and natural casings. And the Sausage Dudes are mission-minded, supporting the Boys and Girls Club of Northeast Florida. Try all four flavors because your cookout deserves better. Now available at all Publix stores in the frozen meat section. Head to Publix today and get your hands on the Sausage Dudes sausage.
Are your kids ready to play this summer? Come check out the Y. Summer is a time for kids to explore new things and expand the limits of their imagination. At the Y Summer Camp, every day is a new adventure. Kids can learn about STEM, arts and humanities, athletic sports, outdoor games, and more. Registration is now open, but space is limited, and spots are filling up quickly. Learn more and find your adventure at FC YMCA.org. Search Summer Day Camp.
What's larger, the Earth's moon or the planet Pluto?
Does your homeowner's insurance company contact you before, during, or after a big storm? If not, then it's time for you to contact Southern Oak Insurance. Find us online at southernoak.com.
Our family protecting yours, Southern Oak Insurance.
The moon is larger than Pluto, as its radius is over 1,000 miles. Pluto, just 715 miles.
Southern Oak Insurance. Our family protecting yours.
Let Hodges Mazda find the perfect Mazda SUV just for you. Lauren Brooks here. Transition from city streets to off-road trails in a newly leased 2024 Mazda CX-50 for only $316 a month, or lease the stunning 5-passenger 2024 Mazda CX-30 for only $298 a month. Our professional non-commissioned sales team always puts your best interests first. Plus, every vehicle purchase comes with 2 years free maintenance. Visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com for the Hodges Mazda difference. See dealer for details, lease, terms, and fees for qualified applicants expires April 30th, 2024.
Imagine the perfect outdoor living space, a beautiful stone kitchen, waterfall, fire pit, pergola, stone walkway. Now there's one place to bring all of your design ideas to life, the Art of Natural Stone on Beach Boulevard and also by Bartram Springs.
Crosser here. When it comes to the business of selling your home, there's one promise I can give you that will deliver, and that promise is ChadAndSandy.com. That's Chad, A-N-D, Sandy.com. How do I know this promise is guaranteed? Because they say so and then they deliver. You see, Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. So whatever problems you think you're having selling your home, there is your simple solution. They're going to buy it if it's not sold for exactly what you want. Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season. Now is the time to maximize your equity, and you can do it with the real estate team of Chad and Sandy. They have a plan and the experience to sell your home fast for maximum cash this spring. John and Ursula in Green Meadows wrote in, we weren't in great health, decided to downsize to an easier place to manage. After 185 days, our home failed to sell. We went to Chad and Sandy, sold in 12 days. You can too at ChadAndSandy.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Stapleton for you on this rainy Thursday. All right, just a few minutes here to recap our NFL draft countdown thus far. We had the Bears take Caleb Williams, Commanders take Jaden Daniels, Patriots Drake May. Then those were the first three fairly obvious. Then we started asking more about what they're targeting. The Cardinals might trade back or take Marvin Harrison Jr. The Chargers trade back or take an offensive tackle like Joe Alt. The Giants, probably a receiver like Malik Nabers. Again, they could trade back, or they could take a quarterback. There's also that thought out there. The Titans, as we just talked to Blaine Bishop, he believes offensive tackle or edge. In a lot of mocks, you do see offensive tackle. Mm-hmm. He mentioned Brock Bowers. If you're trying to go all in for Will Levis and you believe he's your franchise quarterback, which I don't think that, but that's obviously what they believe in Nashville, you certainly could add another weapon in Brock.
Brock is so interesting in this draft because not only like in the amount,
The range
that you see him being mocked, but also every team I feel like that I've talked to personally already that we've talked to, and then ones that, like, if you have friends or whatever that are media or fans of those teams, everybody's like, man, I love him so much, but I don't know if I can justify picking him at this spot.
Which is
wild. We heard it yesterday. He's like, he may be Travis Kelce, but I don't know if it's worth it picking him at 6. And like every team is saying that. Like the Bears are saying the same thing at 9.
Part of that I want to blame. Sorry, Arthur Smith. Like, it's on you, my friend. Like the terrorist that was on the Atlanta Falcons, which we will talk to the other Myles Garrett of Fox 5 Atlanta tomorrow to see what the Falcons are thinking at 8. But if we
just start saying Myles Garrett's joining us tomorrow,
yeah,
because we have Foye Aluakin, people probably would think it's
Myles Garrett. That'll get people tuning in. But if not for Arthur Smith keeping Kyle Pitts in witness protection program and thus people questioning the thought of a tight end going that high at number four that year in the NFL draft, I don't think we would be having nearly as nuanced a conversation as we are regarding Brock Bowers and the value of a rookie tight end contract in the first round versus if you're able to take and get value later on. Because, I mean, once upon a time, T.J. Hockenson went eighth right after Josh Allen in the 2019 NFL draft. He unfortunately was drafted to a Detroit Lions team that was coached by Matt Patricia and was rebuilding throughout the duration of his time there. But now when you look at his production with the Minnesota Vikings, you're like, okay, I see first-round pick potential there. So maybe even if Brock Bowers isn't Kelsey, but he's Hockenson on the Vikings, I mean, if you're the Titans – I think they need to protect Will Levis because it has been a turnstile. Clearly hearing from Blaine Bishop that Mike Vrabel was instrumental in Andre Dillard's signing and saying, well, we're just going to basically come up with like a Band-Aid fix.
Yeah.
It's very clear that people want a foundational pillar at the left and right tackle position in Tennessee. And obviously, because they've run the ball and played great defense, that's been their mantra for so long. How can you not have a good offensive line? At the same time, some juice, maybe that gets more eyeballs on the product up in Nashville.
You mentioned juice. As most people know by now, O.J. Simpson passed away yesterday at the age of 76 after a battle with cancer. We will get to more on that in a little bit, but just wanted to, since you mentioned juice, I just had to at least mention that.
Did you guys know, by the way, he had cancer?
Had no idea.
I did not either.
And I think nowadays, like with Jimmy Buffett, when Jimmy Buffett passed away, I'm a big Jimmy Buffett fan. I didn't know he had cancer either.
Mm-hmm.
I'm appreciative of people who are able to go through that type of stuff and
not make it a public.
And they don't want people to be up, whether it's in their business or just so worried about them that, you know, they're already worried they're going to pass away before they even do. Like, there's just so many things that I feel like crazy people do. And so I can fully respect that they want to fight the battle in privacy. And then, of course, the family asked for privacy now, too.
Yeah, absolutely. We will continue with that conversation regarding O.J. Simpson. What is his legacy? Because I know that's been hotly debated on Twitter this morning. We noted, and Dylan Denmark and RJ pointed out, the last video he posted was a Super Bowl video of him in a Debo Samuel jersey.
I'm so happy.
We'll also get into some other news of the day, including Scott Drew of Baylor passes on the Kentucky job, a swing and a miss for the Wildcats. What comes next to find the successor to John Calipari, who, by the way, noted he met with the team in Arkansas yesterday. There is no team.
Yeah, they are running for the hills. By the way, as you've heard in our Masters updates, Bryson DeChambeau leads all golfers up there in Augusta at 3 under. So a live guy right now is leading. We'll be back on Tension XL 92.5 FM.
Helmets and heels.
From the First Coast Lighting Studios at 1010 XL. Now, a Masters update on 1010 XL. Brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. More and more patches of blue sky are visible early this afternoon after the storms from this morning caused a delay of 2.5 hours. Jon Rahm tees off in about 15 minutes. Masters rookie Nick Dunlap is included in the traditional grouping of defending champion and U.S. amateur champion, even though Dunlap is no longer an amateur. He turned pro 2 months ago. Dunlap told SiriusXM he's fired up to play with Rahm and Matt Fitzpatrick.
I got the really cool pairing. I'm glad the Masters or whoever was in the committee that decided to do that. I appreciate that. I know it's typically it's supposed to be an amateur, but no, it's going to be a really cool opportunity for me to try to learn from John and Matthew, and I'm looking forward to the pairing.
And just before turning pro, Dunlap won at PGA West in January, becoming the first amateur to win a PGA Tour event since Phil Mickelson in 1991. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Remembering great moments in golf history, sponsored by Prevagen. Prevagen is the most recommended memory support brand by pharmacists. 1986 PGA Championship at the Inverness Club in Toledo, Ohio. Sunday weather resulted in a Monday finish for the final group of Bob Tway and Greg Norman. Leading by 4 shots through 54 holes, Norman's edge evaporated for good at the 18th hole when Tway holed his greenside bunker shot to win his first and only career major. With this great moment in golf history, I'm Kevin Kugler.
Free. Who doesn't love free?
With Milo's rewards, you get the member-only treatment that's actually worth it. Enjoy free member gifts you'll love. And once you reach Silver Key status, you can get free standard shipping. Because Lowe's knows nothing feels better than free. Learn more about our new loyalty program at lowes.com/Milo's rewards today. Program subject to terms and conditions. See lowes.com/terms for details. Member gifts may be subject to additional terms and restrictions. See lowes.com/shipping terms for details. Subject to change.
There are four players at 3-under to start the day at the 88th Masters. Let's check the leaderboard, sponsored by Prevagen. Prevagen is the most recommended memory support brand by pharmacists. 2020 U.S. Open champion Bryson DeChambeau, Ryan Fox, and Ben On all birdie the first three holes to push to 3-under. DeChambeau's now through five, Fox through four. Erik van Rooyen is also 3-under. He was in the first group to tee off today. Van Rooyen is now making the turn. At 2-under par, Jake Knapp, the Masters rookie, along with 2016 Masters champion Danny Willett, and reigning British amateur champion Christo Lamprecht, who hits at a mile and stands 6'8". Among those at 1-under, Sergio Garcia, former Masters champ. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emrick, Westwood One Sports.
The flagship station of the Jacksonville Jaguars, WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach, WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
When it comes to towing products, your safety on the road is the priority at Cannons of Jacksonville. Whether it's a heavy-duty tow hitch, trailer frame, wiring, gooseneck, tow bar, or any other towing accessory, Cannons has decades of experience to ensure your towing setup is installed with precision and reliability. Visit CannonsOfJax.com to explore a range of products and schedule your installation. Cannons of Jacksonville, your trusted partner for a smoother tow.
Bold City Heating and Air is truly a family-owned and operated local company and treats all customers like family. Don't be fooled by the out-of-towners, equity firms, and national corporations that use local names. There's one name you can trust when it comes to your home's AC cooling system. Bold City Heating and Air. Jacksonville grown and entirely loyal to this community. Don't wait until it's too late. Schedule your summer maintenance now by visiting boldcityac.com.
Oh boy, the Masters is here, Tiger is in the field, and the Live guys are back at the majors again. Mia here, and if you haven't signed up for MyBookie, you need to sign up this week. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, live betting too. I'm telling you, if you haven't signed up yet for MyBookie, do it for Masters Week. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that. Make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you can still live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up to 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. This is one of the most fun betting weeks of the year, and you can hit winners for long odds. Promo code 1010XL. Bet with my bookie.
An ACL tree with prolonged pain and rehabilitation. Hi, I'm Dr. George Bari. I'm a sports medicine orthopedic surgeon who grew up right here in Jacksonville and then went on to train with the world-renowned Dr. James Andrews. At Bari Orthopedics, we use the most current techniques to get you back on the field with less pain and quicker rehabilitation. We treat all types of sports injuries with the newest techniques available. Please call us for consultation or visit BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I orthopedics.com.
E.T. here, and it's time for the Taste of Golf at TPC Sawgrass, April 24th. Join me for fine cuisine from chefs from the top golf clubs in our area, craft cocktails, games, and unique auction items. This is one of the most charitable events in our area. Come network with a sophisticated audience who is passionate about golf and its values, all while impacting the youth in our community. All proceeds benefit First Tee North Florida. For tickets, go to tasteofgolf.com. Come on, somebody.
This is Molly McDonald with your 1010XL Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. Scottie Scheffler looks to recapture glory at the Masters yet again. The top-ranked golfer in the world will tee off at 112 today and believes he has done all he can do to prepare himself for the victory.
I've done the work. I've done everything I could. I've checked all the boxes, and I've done everything to where I can go out here and play well. And so I can go out and compete freely knowing that I've done what I'm supposed to do in my preparation. And then when it comes time to compete, I'm just trying to soak in the competition, go out there, have fun, be committed to my shots. I'm focused mostly on my mental attitude. You know, I'm not looking at results. I'm just trying to focus as much on my process as I can.
The Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp secured back-to-back wins to open the series against Charlotte, winning 2-1 last night. Thirsty Thursday is back tonight as the Shrimp enter Game 3 of the series, first pitch at 7:05. It's 76 degrees at 1 o'clock, time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
What you know about love? You said our love wouldn't be. You said you were my girlfriend. Some girl you turned out to be.
I got to go see this guy, Donovan Frankenreiter, at Underbelly not too long ago. It was super fun. And Taylor, I know I asked you on air when we were on Helmets and Heels at night if you'd ever been to Underbelly, and you said yes. And yeah, that was my first time there. I just discovered it. Absolutely loved it. All right, let's get your take, Taylor, since you had to miss the very beginning of the show on Josh Allen's press conference yesterday.
Yeah. I loved it. I think that seeing that emotion out of a player, because we talk about it a lot, and the fact of, we did it even with Calvin, they want to be here, and it's always kind of like, okay, sure. They want the money at the end of the day, but you really did feel emotion in Josh of like, yes, he got a payday, so I'm sure he's pumped about that, but it also seemed like he genuinely was like, I started my NFL career here, and I want to finish my NFL career here, and we see that genuine trait of Josh through the press conferences and through other interactions with the media and stuff like that. And I know you had like the situation with the, hey, Lauren, that type of thing. And it's just, those are little moments that, so when you see that side of a player, you already love it and already love that, the human side of it. But then you get to this and you have a season the way he did. And I was reading the text line yesterday and our Twitter, because we had our question of the day yesterday of what was your favorite Josh Allen moment. And we went through some of those yesterday, but some of the comments just genuinely were making me laugh, like the negative ones of he's the most inconsistent. One of them said he's the most inconsistent player that we in Jags history. And that blew my mind.
Sir, that's quite a long list. I don't think you can quantify by putting him at the top of it.
I was genuinely confused by that statement because I was like, even if, like, first of all, to count on someone getting 17 sacks every season isn't a normal, like, no, not many players hit that mark or even close to that mark in consecutive seasons, especially not their entire career. But he's always been that person who has, and this is with teams that have been disasters around him. So, and that's what I think a lot of people on the years where maybe you didn't get the production out of Josh Allen, and I spoke on it many times, like you want last season, I was like, you're going to need to see this next jump out of Josh Allen to really know what he's worth. And you saw it. You saw it. He's capable of doing it, and you know he's capable of doing it aside people who give him a little bit of help where he's not having to do all of it. And so that's something. But, yeah, I think that you could tell he was excited. You can tell. I know one of the things Mia mentioned was the position about having the best player inside. That was interesting to me. And your tweet was the only one I really saw even talking about it. So
I was literally, like, I just heard it, and I was like, huh. That's interesting, and I, like, tweeted it out, and then, again, we, like, had to debrief about it later because they were like, wait, did he really say that? I'm like...
So what are your what were your thoughts on that initially? Pre-debrief.
When he first said it, because I saw some people, and a couple of you on the text line noted this, too, that you felt like it was almost as if it was a slight against Mike Caldwell, that the best player, i.e. either Josh or Trayvon, wasn't going inside more. Mm-hmm. I don't think that was the case. I think it was a bigger picture discussion of Ryan Nielsen will scheme us up. It's just... And this is no knock on Mike Caldwell because Todd Washington did this too, where you are our left outside linebacker. You are our three technique. You play here. Yeah. And that is your role, and that's what you do. And we've seen it with Ryan Nielsen both in Atlanta and New Orleans. He's got guys lined
everywhere,
up all over the place, and he keeps bodies fresh. And so that's why our conversation in the 12 o'clock hour was regarding, is the thought of an edge rusher at 17 or 48 dead with the extension to Josh Allen, to which I say absolutely not. Mm-hmm. And even if you opt for the corner wide receiver or interior defensive line or whatever route you go, I think they have Bud Dupree on speed dial, personally, because I think if they don't get the edge rusher they want, they will say, okay, we'll tap back into that third wave of free agency and go get a veteran.
I do think Josh Allen might have been not intentionally saying anything bad between the lines about Fully Fatakasi, but that's more what I took away from it is we have more talent now on this defensive front. And yes, with our new defensive coordinator, we're going to be able to mix it up. But it's also because we have a guy like Eric Armstead who might be able to play outside. Yeah. And I don't think Fully Fatakasi
could have played outside.
Yeah. Yeah. Quick Masters update. 5 guys now at 3 under. Oh. So DeChambeau no longer atop the leaderboard himself. Danny Willett, former Masters champ in 2016, one of those 5. So we'll keep you updated when it comes to that. All right, Mia, you asked the question that, like you said, has been hotly debated on Twitter, and that would be, what is the legacy of O.J. Simpson? From an older person's perspective, as far as on this show, not older in general, but I remember the Bronco chase. I remember being at a family reunion.
30 years ago this year, by the way.
Yeah, 30 years ago. I remember watching that. And I remember listening to all the adults talk about how wild that was because he was such a good football player. That's my kind of first memory of O.J., not from being a football player, but from the chase. And then, of course, we all know the acquittal, the very famous acquittal, and the fact that the glove didn't fit and everything like that. So for me, my legacy is definitely the police chasing this guy who it seemed untouchable at one point in time in his life.
The YouTube chat line, as expected, as I noted right off the top of the show, which apologies that there was no YouTube stream for Jaguars today or the end of the drill. Again, if you're just turning on 1010 for the first time today, we had some electrical issues in the building, but we are back up on the air and running, and the YouTube chat line is on fire in a good way. Lil Big Man, don't let OJ is dead distract you from 2,000 yards in a single season.
Right, exactly. I mean, he was a phenomenal football player. It's just when you get away from, or I should say, because it was so long ago and all the other stuff was so public.
Yeah.
I mean, the fact that his ex-wife and her husband were killed, or boyfriend were killed.
Her pool boy.
Right.
Friend, like, yes.
Sure. Like, there was such, to me, there was such obvious guilt, even if the courtroom didn't find that, because he paid excellent lawyers and things like that. But I think, to me, yes, the eventually, like, for instance, I'll bring it to a more recent player, Draymond Green, and not that he has any sort of court issues.
No, no,
but to
nothing
me,
of
oh,
this
basketball no, but to
issues.
Me, yeah, Draymond Green's legacy will always be the ejections and the fighting. Mm-hmm. Like, he has won multiple NBA championships.
But was that OJ's mantra on the football field?
Killer?
Yeah, like, he wasn't like that. I'm not old enough.
Well, I definitely was.
To have watched him play, but, like, it didn't come across as, like let's say, you know, Derrick Henry with the bulldozer. Like, was O.J. Simpson, like, a bulldozer?
I think his nickname was Juice because he was so fast.
Correct. Mm-hmm. If anything,
why he was fast in the Broncos.
If anything, he was a prequel to the modern running back that we were just discussing with Blaine Bishop of 104.5 The Zone.
Yeah.
Having that quick burst, having that speed in the open field, that, as he said, Tennessee hasn't had a running back like that in eons.
Yeah.
And I think that OJ was the precursor in a lot of ways to that. And so I don't think it was like a smash mouth. Like, Draymond, and the reason I bring this up is, if we're to make the Draymond, like, what was your style of play, and then your off-the-court antics, like, Draymond's style of play is banging on the boards, you know, like, physicality. And getting rebounds.
Yeah.
And so that's where, again, we're not trying to compare a guy who may or may not have murdered people to a guy who just gets ejected for games and yells at refs and players.
Yeah.
But
gets suspended, too.
But it is important to note that, like, your off-the-field actions can reflect and overshadow what you did on the court or on the field.
And it's a shame. He's obviously, OJ's not the only example of that. We have, even in recent history, what is Deshaun Watson always going to be in
the
future? Because the way he started his career, it looked like he was going to be one of those top quarterbacks. And because of his off-field antics, it almost feels like it halted a lot of that. But when it comes to, it's a shame that when you go back, because when you do look at OJ's numbers and what he was able to do, when it comes to, obviously, that 2,000-yard rushing season, but even around that, all of the years around that, hitting 15 and 18 and 16 touchdowns and 14 touchdowns. And it sucks that, especially for someone like me who was born in 90, all I know, like, my whole first 10 years of my life, because that happened 94, 95, 96, was, like, in the midst of all of the trial and all of that stuff going on. So that is, like, my first memories and my most, like, vivid memories of just, like, hearing about the trial and hearing about the Bronco and hearing about that. And at that time, people were not talking about his football because they were like, okay, well, he's not a very good person if this is true, if this happened. And so it wasn't something that was addressed. So it wasn't until later in life when you could go back and, like, I don't want to say forgotten, because it's obviously not forgotten, but got pushed back enough to where people started talking about his ability on the football field a little bit more. But then as soon as that started happening, then all of these documentaries come out showing the trial and showing the court case and the behind the scenes of what was really going on with all of the lawyers and with OJ, and is he lying, is it real, all of that stuff. So the moment that you felt like you started seeing a little bit more of the football, again, it got you got reminded of the whole all of the other off the field stuff. So it's a shame almost, because it's a shame obviously with the whole situation that happened, but that you can't, most people can't just talk about OJ Simpson as a football player.
That's correct. And by the way, I didn't know this because I'm not connected with anyone in Las Vegas, but apparently in February of 2024, this is according to ABC News, a Las Vegas television station reported that he was undergoing treatment for an unspecified cancer. But then that day, OJ posted a video on Twitter denying rumors that he was in hospice care, but he didn't deny that he was ill.
And interesting.
So, yeah,
okay.
So Las Vegas, someone obviously from the hospital, I'm going to guess, must have told someone, even though that's totally a violation of HIPAA. But that's my guess, is that somebody told somebody, and then they got it to a Las Vegas TV station. But of course, when OJ comes out and says, well, no, that's not necessarily true, he wasn't in hospice care at that point in time, but he, like I said, he didn't deny that he had cancer. But as someone who has lost several people in my lifetime, and most people listening probably have as well, to cancer, it can be such an ugly disease. And I'm at least glad for him that he was able to deal with it out of the public eye and deal with it as a family. All right, let's switch gears to Kentucky basketball, Mia. You have Scott Drew staying at Baylor. So who is going to be the next Kentucky basketball coach?
Yeah, so he just released a statement. In our program, we strive to put Jesus first, then others, then ourselves. We truly believe God has called my family and I to continue our work here at Baylor, surrounded by the best people and community anyone could be blessed to have.
That sounds very much more religious than I would have expected it
Scott
to.
Drew's a pretty, he's a man of faith.
Okay.
And obviously he's the mentor to our good friend Matthew Driscoll of UNF so many people there.
Texas is probably a better, Baylor is probably a more, a better environment for something like that than Lexington, Kentucky is what I would guess, just because of all of the bourbon that exists in Lexington.
He's also 53 years old. Like, I was stunned that John Calipari was 65 and is still coaching and is taking on a new venture, which we could get into that as well. And look, I think Scott Drew is, I don't want to say he's a young or an old 53, because when he took over that Baylor program and the state that it was in, the mess that it was, the mess that that entire athletic program, minus the women's basketball team, was, it can't be overstated enough. And so I think that he truly believes he's changing lives. And I also think he believes that, I'm 53, why would I want to literally enter the terror dome that is Big Blue Nation and have to deal with that sort of pushback of, if I'm not getting top five recruits every year, if I'm not going to the Final Four every year, it's the end of the world. Versus at Baylor, he won a national title, the first in their program's history, and everything else is going to be forgotten. And I'm not saying Scott Drew's going to bottom out now because he's got a nice contract extension, assumingly, after these potential discussions with Kentucky. But I do think that he's in a very comfortable spot and he's in a very comfortable part of his life. And so I don't blame him in the least. I also believe what's being reported on Twitter is true, that he may be the first person in history to turn down both the Kentucky and the Louisville job in the same offseason.
What type of coach do you think it's going to take to accept that job?
That's the problem.
Yeah.
That's literally because of what John Calipari made that job. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you go back in time, like, Tubby Smith was a good coach, but he wasn't out here proclaiming the world of one and done and, you know, flashing around, here's my $3 billion in NBA contracts that my guys have gotten. Mm-hmm. He wasn't the character that Cal is and was at Kentucky. There also was a layoff that people forget between Tubby, who, you know, Rick Pitino, Tubby, Gillespie, and then it was John Calipari, and John Calipari has been the coach for 15 years.
Yeah.
And so that's why Kentucky fans, it is Camelot again, even if the results in the NCAA tournament haven't showed for it, the standard has been raised. And so, I mean, it's kind of, I mean, I don't want to compare it to the Alabama job, because the Alabama job is different in that they've actually won multiple national titles in the last 15 years, as opposed to just one.
But the pressure is
heavy. And the fan base still has a high standard.
Right.
Yeah. So it's like Florida football, except Florida hasn't won the title in longer than Kentucky hasn't won.
Yeah, that's actually probably a good analogy.
That's what, come from being,
but even more pressure built.
Yeah, like from being a, obviously a Gators fan, but I see all the really fanatical people on social media where I talk to them, and the pressure to win at Florida. I mean, you're on the hot seat if you don't win the first year, and I think that's going to be the same as for the Kentucky basketball coach. Hopefully, when it comes to Kalen DeBoer at Alabama, they have a bigger picture and they understand that it may not be immediate. Even though their fans will still go crazy, but as long as leadership feels that way, then Kalen DeBoer will have a better chance.
So to answer your question, Taylor, from people I've talked to, like now that Scott Drew said no, and knowing Nate Oates has already said he's out, and not to mention that would have been a $20 million buyout at the University of Alabama, all signs really point to Mark Pope, the head coach of BYU, who was the captain of the 1996 national title team at Kentucky, and would he be willing to go back to the Bluegrass State? He is part of the Church of Latter-day Saints. He has four daughters that I think range in age from like 13 to 20. Are he and his wife willing to leave a very nice area in BYU where, hey, like you make the NCAA tournament, you go to the Big 12, and you have success in that first year, you make the tournament. I know you got bounced in the round of 64, but it feels like you're building something. You were a top 25 team most of the year. Do you really want to give that up to go to Kentucky, which Mark Pope isn't even like a Kentucky guy? Like, he finished his college career there, but he's from Washington State. He started his college basketball career at Washington State. And while I think he bleeds blue in the sense that, yes, that's where he has his degree from, I'm not, I think he knows the other side of the coin all too well. And so it'll be curious if that's who they go out and get. He, you know, he's a very level-headed guy. And to whoever takes this job is going to be a stark contrast to Cal, unless Kentucky does the funniest thing ever, and they go out and they hire Rick Pitino. That is the only way that you would just continue the madness. I mean, I've seen T.J. Otzelberger of Iowa State's name floated a time or two. And
he's, you know, 71, by the way. And yes, of course, he's still coaching.
He's still coaching.
He's 71.
Yeah. He can't quit, Lauren. He loves it. He's married at the game.
I'll just the coaching odds right now. So still have Billy Donovan at the top, which we've talked about that one. Tommy Lloyd second, Arizona. Mark Pope behind that, and then Otzelberger behind that. Bruce Pearl, Shaka Smart, and Brad Underwood are the ones behind that.
Yeah. Oh, Brad, that'd be interesting.
I think Shaka Smart's a really good coach. Shaka,
but I think the whole reason Shaka left Texas was because he was tired of the machine. He was tired of the pressure from boosters and fans, and he said, I'm going to go back to my little old Wisconsin where, you know, if I win, I'm celebrated, and as long as we're above 500, like Marquette fans are like, okay, he's building towards something. Yeah. I'm also very proud that we somehow managed to get both O.J. Simpson and Rick Pitino in the same segment in 2024.
Hey, that's what we do. When we come back, I want to get it to the NFL draft. As far as the analysts who've been the most accurate over the last few years, we will get to that and a whole lot more on 1010 XL 92.5 FM.
Helmets and Heels is switched on by First Coast Lighting and Fans, upscale lighting, fans, and home decor
on 1010 XL.
Now, a Masters update on 1010 XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. Rory McIlroy isn't interested in being the moral compass of golf anymore. He's long given that up as he focuses on his game while the PGA Tour LIV Golf League battle plays out. McIlroy this week trying to win the only major title he hasn't collected. Tiger Woods has collected them all multiple times over, and he sees a green jacket in McIlroy's future.
I think that Rory will be a great Masters champion one day, and it could be this week. You know, you never know. I just think that, the talent that he has, the way he plays the game, and the way the golf course fits his eye, it's just a matter of time.
McIlroy is grouped with the only player ranked ahead of him, number one Scottie Scheffler, along with Xander Schauffele. Rory bombed his tee shot, as usual, about 350 yards to the left side of the fairway. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Now your ideas don't have to wait. Now they have everything they need to come to life. Dell Technologies and Intel are creating technology that loves ideas, loves expanding your business, evolving your passions. We push what technology can do, so great ideas can happen right now. Find out how to bring your ideas to life at Dell.com. Welcome to now.
Even with a stiff wind from the south, Augusta National is ripe for scoring after the rain from this morning has softened the course. Let's check the leaderboard, sponsored by Grainger. With supplies and solutions for every industry, Grainger has the right product for you. Call clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Eric Van Rooyen, one of the first players to tee off today after the weather delayed the start of the 88th Masters by 2.5 hours. Van Rooyen, 3-under through 11 holes. Also at 3-under, Danny Willett, Masters champion in 2016. The British amateur champion, Christo Lamprecht, at 6'8". He's a student at Georgia Tech. Lamprecht is through 8 holes. Bryson DeChambeau, former major champion, U.S. Open in 2020, 3-under through 7. Ryan Fox, the Kiwi, is 3-under through 6. Ben Ahn is at 2-under. Defending champion John Rahm landing his approach at 1 in the fringe below the green, but he saved his par. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
So you want a new ride, but you've got to get payments to fit your monthly budget, right? Well, if you want low payments, then you've got to go to Arlington Toyota Pre-Owned and save today. How does this sound? Just $500 down and $288 per month gets you a pre-owned 2021 Toyota Corolla. Or you choose a pre-owned 2021 Camry, RAV4, or Tacoma for just $500 down and $388 per month. Arlington Pre-Owned will even help you with your credit. Get a fresh start with help from Arlington's friendly credit for everyone pre-approval helper. It's all about getting you approved. And remember, you can buy pre-owned with total confidence thanks to Arlington's 30-day exchange program. That's 30 days to love your pre-owned purchase or exchange it. But don't wait. You've got to go to Arlington Pre-Owned today if you want just $500 down, low payments, 30-day exchange, and friendly credit for everyone. Shop in person 10939 Atlantic Boulevard and online at arlingtontoyota.com today.
It doesn't get any better than live country music. Enjoy Daryl Ray at Players Grill Miramar this Friday at 7 p.m. with discount cocktails while the local star rocks out. Players Grill Miramar, where the neighborhood meets.
This is my bar.
I'm here with Clayton Blomberg of Underwoods. Clayton, in all business, there's supposed to be some mission statement that keeps the business on course for the long term. Can you share it with us?
David, at Underwoods, because of the fact, we sell the most precious metals and gemstones put together by the best craftsmen in truly stunning pieces that are worn for adornment, adding that most of the time these pieces of jewelry are being given to celebrate life's most important occasions, it just doesn't seem right to call it a mission statement. Instead, because all of us at Underwoods are driven by a passion for what we do, we call it a passion statement. It goes like this. At Underwoods, we're devoted to being the best jeweler in the South. We accomplish this through our long-term philosophy that quality in merchandise, presentation, personal service, and our integrity will bring the customer back to shop with us. This same Underwood experience will create new customers through the endorsements from our satisfied customers. Keeping in mind, the returning customer sets Underwood's future.
Underwood Jewelers.
Tired of dealing with clogged drains? What about those bad smells coming from your pipes? No matter how big or small your commercial or residential project may be, my friends at Duck Duck Rooter can handle it. Contact them today for all your plumbing, septic, and air conditioning needs at 904-862-6769. And while I have your attention, Duck Duck Rooter is also hiring plumbers. They offer excellent weekly pay, health insurance, paid holidays, 401k, and more. Apply now at DuckDuckRooter.com, and they will call you for an interview.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them. Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability.
You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
At Honda, we appreciate all the comparisons to other vehicles. And no matter how many times they compare their vehicles to a Honda, only a Honda is a Honda. Remember, value, quality, safety. There is no substitute. Visit your local Honda dealer now and experience the difference. You're
shrimping about. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, is home all weekend at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. It's Coors Light Thirsty Thursday tonight, then it's Red Shirt Friday, fireworks tomorrow presented by the Big D Building Center, and the first 2,000 fans on Saturday get free Jumbo Shrimp Pajama Pants. Plus more fireworks presented by Vistar and First Watch. Then it's Baptist Health Sunday Family Fun Day. Log on to jackshrimp.com for tickets.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
The All-Pro Roofing phone line connects you to some of the most sports-connected minds in the country.
You mean you can actually contact these people?
Listen for great phone interviews all day on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
We'll talk on the phone.
On 1010XL.
This is Hayes Carlion for Skylife Elite. Have you ever thought about aircraft ownership as another potential revenue stream and as a tool for tax savings? Put your tax money to work for you while enjoying the benefits of private personal travel. Skylife Elite has over a decade of experience in business aviation and can guide you through the process with their expert staff. Call my friends over at Skylife Elite at 490-9332 or find them at flyskylife.com to get the rundown on everything owning an airplane can do for you.
If you are having problems related to selling your home, here's your solution. You just have not discovered ChadandSandy.com. That's ChadandSandy.com. Listen, maybe the problem is you need more space for your office or growing family, or perhaps you're worried about settling for less money with a lowball instant offer. We've got one guarantee here that always rings true. Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. It's as simple as that. So you need to call 904-414-6200 or go to chadandsandy.com like Jonathan in Mount Pleasant did. The only thing standing between me and my dream of traveling in my RV was the sale of my Mount Pleasant home. I heard Chad and Sandy on the radio and called. Crazy results. In just 3 days, I received multiple offers for full asking price. So you don't have the problems you think you do. You have solutions and promises with Chad and Sandy. Go to chadandsandy.com or call 904-414-6200. 6200 at chadandsandy.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
I look up at the television here at 1010XL World Headquarters. I see our friend of the program, Laura Rutledge, who was kind enough to join us last week, leading the Masters studio coverage from the field at Augusta, where play has resumed after a rain interruption slash delay this morning because of those storms that rolled through. I also see my good friend George Kittle, also Kirk Cousins, but George Kittle, which reminded me, ladies, we never got to some of the fun tweets that have been sent via the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures over the last 8 days of us being a daily program. I will read the most recent of them for you now. From the Durham Bulls: good morning. We scored 28 runs in a game. Oh no, sorry. They scored 20. So here we go. They won 28 to 10. Preface it. They won 28 to 10.
A baseball game.
The Durham Bulls, which are a rival of the Jumbo Shrimp, they're a AAA baseball team. And then they tweeted it out, just another day in the International Football League. Ha, 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 because it's the International League is the AAA division, right? Good morning. We've scored 28 in a game as many times as Iowa football did last season.
Ooh, burn.
That, of course, is on the heels of so many of you, especially Tim Reynolds down in Miami and the good folks at The Athletic, who were quick to point out that, yes, Caitlin Clark did score more points by herself this season than the Iowa football program this year and in quite some time. Actually, I believe it was her entire four-year career.
Ooh, yeah, that's no bueno. All right, so transitioning to football then, Taylor, when we talk about NFL draft, of course, we all try and figure out who's going to which team, but certain analysts are better than others at figuring that out.
Yeah, so I found an article. It's on tapsportsnet.com, and it's something he's been calculating this for the past, like, 5 years. So I remember seeing it for the first time 5 years ago and being like, this is really cool. But it was obviously only 1 year
worth of data.
Yeah. That he started tracking. But at the what he does is he goes through, and at the end of a season, they go and get a number. You know, they have numbers for everything, but it's like they call it AV, but it's used heavily in this analysis. They described AV as putting a single numerical value on a player's season at any position from any year. So they go through all of their statistical numbers and put this AV number on players.
Which is
at the end of the
approximate
season,
value.
Approximate value of, yes, they just are grading this player pretty much for their season. So they take that and they go through all of the draft picks and they give them all their number that they are signed. And then he goes through and he calculates how accurate each of the people that make these mock drafts and compares it to the way they were actually drafted in the NFL draft.
So it's analytics based off of analytics.
Yes. It's a lot of information. If you read the article, though, it's honestly fascinating because it breaks it down by position. It breaks it down, like I said, right now he's done 5 years, so it's a five-year average that is being kind of calculated in this particular article. So I just figured it'd be kind of fun to go through some of the more accurate which of the analysts slash draft, because some of them are analysts, some of them are like consensus numbers, some are PFF, which is more of like a model number because they use statistics themselves there. But and it also breaks it down. So top 5, top 10, top 25, top 50, top 75, top 100, and then final. But it's really interesting because in the last 5 year, in the 5 year average for the top 100 big board rankings, The Athletic has been the most accurate, and that's over the NFL draft. So the way the NFL draft actually pans out and the way that these numbers, that these players are graded and where they are drafted, The Athletic has predicted.
They're better than reality.
Better. Yes.
That's amazing. Yeah, I wonder if teams have picked up on this to where they're talking to their scouts about what The Athletic is, you know, what their analytics say about players.
Yeah. They're like, have you seen the beast yet?
Well, speaking of Dame Brugler, did you see this in this wonderful analysis? Dame Brugler is on his own. He's independent of this consensus. And he is ranked, I believe, 5th between Mel Kiper, DraftWire, Daniel Jeremiah. He was ranked 9th and 10th in terms of his top 5 and top 10 average over the last 5 years. Mm-hmm. But then he's 3,
nails it
4.
For the rest.
Right. And I'm curious, when did he join The Athletic? Because, I mean, are we including him in the consensus or he is on his own?
And that's what I guess his is, because The Athletic, so many different people do their mock. So I'm assuming they, kind of like we did our mock draft, our draft guide here, which is a consensus of 8 different people. But then you all each individually had your own. So I'm guessing Dame Brugler on his own had his top 5, top 10 that have not been so great, but he's really good when it comes to later. But that is piled into some of the other athletic people who probably are highly focused on that top 5, top 10. But I'll just go through some of this because, like I said, it was really interesting. So when you look at I'll say the order first. So The Athletic is the best in the last 5 year average, and then the NFL draft of how they actually are drafted. Behind that, it's Mel Kiper, DraftWire, Dame Brugler, Scouts Inc., Daniel Jeremiah, PFF, Lance Zierlein, and then the Draft Network. So if you guys are keeping in mind of which mock drafts to go read, this is helpful because it shows who's been accurate and at which level they've been the most accurate.
And I've got The Athletic, Daniel Jeremiah, and Mel Kiper's all picks for the Jaguars at 17 when we get ready for that.
Yes. So let's start with that. Let's start with, let's just say The Athletic. So when it goes through, and it goes through and breaks by position group to, for example. So what the most accurate in guessing position group for quarterback has been the NFL draft, the way that they've done it in the last 5 years. Next behind that has been Sunday Slate is something that was not included in that top. So it kind of ranks that the Athletic is fourth. So if you want to say, hey, let's see who's the most accurate for the quarterbacks the last 5 years, you're probably going to go look at the Athletic's guide because it seems like they're the most accurate in that. They're the most accurate in a lot of the things. But the NFL draft has nailed wide receiver, quarterback, offensive line, defensive line, safety. Those are their best categories. Mel Kiper's nailed tight end. And this is just one I'm going through one rankings. The Athletic for running backs. The Athletic is number one. And then when you go to, like, the second best, because obviously the NFL draft itself holds a lot of the number ones for that, if you're going to second or third, the Athletic has been super accurate with tight end and offensive line, not so much with cornerbacks.
Okay,
we got to file that one away.
Yep.
Daniel Jeremiah has really good when it comes to defensive line, linebackers, safeties, corners, but has struggled big time when it comes to cornerbacks, wide receivers, and running backs.
Ah, all interesting.
Yeah.
So then we take all that, and then, like I said, I've got their picks for the Jaguars. We'll start with the Athletic, since we pretty much are crowning them as the queen bee in this conversation. So the Athletic's most recent mock draft has the Jaguars selecting a guy we have not talked about other than maybe briefly mentioning early last week. Defensive tackle out of Texas, Byron Murphy II. Now, they, of course, acknowledge that the Jaguars did add Arik Armstead, but they still could use some explosion up the middle.
Like the conversation we were having about Josh Allen suggesting that they need to rotate guys. It can't just be you play this position and you play for 85% of the snaps. It needs to be let's move you over here, let's move you over there, let's give you a little bit of a breather because now I need you to just get after the quarterback on the edge.
Yeah. Right. And as far as the mock draft from Mel Kiper, he has Mia's guy, and I only say Mia's guy.
So, just side note really quick, though, because that was the Athletics.
The
Athletics has is 10th when it comes to their defensive line picking and 8th in linebackers. So that is their weakest two positions that they've had the last 5 years, is guessing those ones.
Okay, interesting. Mel Kiper has the Jaguars taking, again, I say Mia's guy just because he went to Iowa, Cooper DeJean.
Right, which has been a name that's kind of gained traction, even hearing Nate Tice yesterday on the Athletic Football Show. Like, there's been – Cooper DeJean is a fascinating prospect because, yes, he played a lot of zone at Iowa, but he did – as much as he wasn't that star position, he played in a 4-2-5 lineup in Iowa's defense. And he's extremely disciplined in his approach. I believe he can play press man just because of what a freak athlete he is, and he showed that at his individual workout earlier this week or late last week, whenever it was. And so he's going to be an interesting one. I think the medicals have pretty much cleared for the most part. He obviously was able to participate in his pro day. I don't think he suffered the tibia injury that he had, that he suffered out of practice in November. I don't think it was one of those that, like, is going to derail his first year in the NFL. But for me, with Cooper DeJean, it's also the national discourse. Not that national discourse, but the one surrounding, will he eventually have to move to safety?
And that's always a question. Yeah. And how has
so he has Kiper not
done?
Fared well in that. And those two, cornerback and safety, were his two. But so also keep it. It's not that they've predicted that they've gone and they've been wrong. It's that the talent that they have predicted at those two positions haven't panned out in the NFL very well.
Right, which is good to know. And finally, Daniel Jeremiah selects the guy I selected on the mock draft earlier this week with Las Vegas, Brian Thomas Jr., the wide receiver out of LSU. We all know about his speed with the 4.33 at the combine. He also caught the 17 touchdowns last season. That was the best in the country.
And that is Daniel Jeremiah's big board?
No, that is his mock draft.
His mock draft. Okay, so I think he'll have one more mock draft out next week, too. So it could change up there. Quick note from the text line brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures. From the 574, our guy in Indiana. The Athletic doesn't know that Byron Murphy has short arms. Probably missing that one.
And that is not Trent's thing. Just because I know two of the positions real quick that the Jags have been looking at. Obviously, we talk about wide receiver and we talk about corner. It seems like those are the two main ones we've really talked about. And so if you're looking for the most accurate who have been able to evaluate that talent that ends up working out into the NFL, the NFL draft board is number one. But behind that, Scouts Inc., Dane Brugler, The Athletic, and Lance Zierlein have been the most accurate with wide receivers. And then when it comes to the defensive line slash edge, Daniel Jeremiah, PFF, Scouts Inc., Mel Kiper, And then when it comes to the cornerback, NFL draft, let's just go ahead and say this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th most accurate the way that they've actually ended up drafting corners. The best has been Scouts, Inc., Dane Brugler, Daniel Jeremiah, and Sunday Slate are the most accurate when predicting those cornerback guys that are headed into the NFL.
Ah, well, good stuff, Taylor. You did a lot of work, and I feel like the people listening appreciate all the work that this guy did as well. So that way they can just sit back and let us tell them who to take.
Yeah. And I did send the link to this article to a couple of you on the text line, brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures. If you want it, just hit us up at 641-1010. Also left it in the comments section of the YouTube chat line. And so if you're curious to see more the performance reports for the NFL draft analysts around the country, which one should you actually choose? Which should you not? Let us know. We'll make sure you get that link. This is Helmets and Heels.
From the First Coast Lighting Studios at 1010 XL.
This is Helmets and Heels.
Your home for Florida Gators baseball is 1010 XL.
The Gators look for a weekend full of wins against South Carolina. Friday night, Saturday, and Sunday afternoon on 1010 AM.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
When it comes to towing products, your safety on the road is the priority at Cannons of Jacksonville. Whether it's a heavy-duty tow hitch, trailer frame, wiring, gooseneck, tow bar, or any other towing accessory, Cannons has decades of experience to ensure your towing setup is installed with precision and reliability. Visit CannonsOfJax.com to explore a range of products and schedule your installation. Cannons of Jacksonville, your trusted partner for a smoother tow.
Oh boy, the Masters has begun. Tiger is on the prowl and in the fields, and those LIV Golf guys are back at the majors. Mia here, and if you haven't signed up for my bookie, you need to sign up for Masters Week. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, live betting too. Could the weather in Augusta this morning cause some chaos? They just said the course is a little bit softer than expected. Take advantage of that and make some money. And even though the Masters has already begun, you can still live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. I'm looking at an 18-hole match bet between Ludvig Åberg and Tommy Fleetwood right now. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up 50%. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus $50 minimum. Promo code again is 1010XL. Bet with my bookie.
AgPro Sign and Drive event is offering 0% for 84 months with no money down on a John Deere compact utility tractor with loader. Limited time offer. Visit your local AgPro dealer today. Offer ends April 30th, 2024. Subject to approved credit. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
It's kind of like his own private locker, and you're his guest.
Every time we talk, I'm reinvigorated by my love of the game.
Hayes Carline here. Find my blog at 1010XL.com.
Hayes Blog is brought to you by Roland Reich Plumbing, where quality and experience count.
It's tune-up time, and Florida Home AC, the official AC partner of the Jaguars, wants to partner with you for a cool summer season. Tune up your AC unit right now so it's running at peak performance when you need it most. Just call 777-4300 and order a tune-up for just $59. Keep your unit humming at optimal level. Log on to floridahomeac.com and take advantage of their savings. Keep cool with Florida Home AC. That's 777-4300.
Are you 18 years or older? Just got married, just got divorced, or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700. Office is Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
Do you have clicking, popping, swelling, or pain in your knee or shoulder? This can be due to arthritic changes in your joints. Over time, you have wear and tear of your cartilage. I'm Dr. George Bari, and here at Bari Orthopedics, we have numerous ways to treat your arthritis, such as regenerative medicine, including PRP, and joint replacements with CT guidance for accuracy down to the millimeter. If you are experiencing any of these symptoms, call us for an appointment today, or log on to BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's BahriOrthopedics.com.
Any adventure, any task, any time. There's a CF Moto Utility ATV or UTV for any rider. See the full lineup at Ride Now Beach Boulevard. Venture seekers can start with the trail-tested capability and comfort of the Z-Force lineup. For the ultimate in UTV performance, check out the Z-Force 950. Find your utility ATV at Ride Now Beach Boulevard or online at cfmotousa.com. ATVs are recommended for the use only by riders age 16 years and older. ATVs can be hazardous to operate. CF Moto recommends approved training course for safety and training information.
We love talking sports on 1010XL, and I-9 Sports love giving kids the perfect way to grow up playing sports. Summer and fall registration is underway. If you log on to i9sports.com, you'll see all they've got to offer for kids 3 and up. And don't forget to enter 1010 in the promo code for a discount on registration. Year-round sports all across the First Coast, from St. John's, Duval to Clay. Summer and fall registration open right now. Fort Family Field in Westside Middle or online at i9sports.com. Get your kids in the game with i9.
Patriot Roofing Services, specializing in all types of commercial and residential roofing and repairs, gutters, sun tubes, skylights as well. 10-year workmanship warranty, financing available, military and senior citizen discounts, no subcontractors. Mention this ad at the time of the estimate and receive $500 off any new re-roof. Call Mark today, 982-4052, 982-4052, licensed and insured.
Hello, this is Father Nicholas Lowe, and I want to talk to you about not being afraid of the crosses of life. Life can be difficult. Maybe today you're carrying a cross of worry or stress. Let me encourage you to remember that when Christ got on the big cross at Golgotha, he destroyed all the little crosses that we face in our life. He set us free from fear, worry, and anxiety. Our job is not to be carried by the cross, but to be carried by our faith.
For more inspiration, log on to stjohnthedivine.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah and Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Mentioned the Durham Bulls scored 28 runs in a minor league baseball game earlier this week. I will refrain for Lauren's sake from noting how many runs Florida State scored in a single game.
I said it yesterday.
I know you did.
That doesn't bother me.
I just thought about
it. It's just baseball.
I know.
It just happens.
We wanted to give a shout out to all of our local baseball teams. So, hey, listen, Noles fans, you're feeling mighty fine right now.
Definitely that, because somebody on the text line when we were talking about who could go to Kentucky, they said, tell Kentucky we'll send Leonard Hamilton that their way. That
was I'm sure FSU fans are ready to part ways with him after the last 2 years have not been good. By the way, a little tease for our show tomorrow after we just broke down all of those potential players for the Jaguars that mock drafters have. I did do some digging into Dane Brugler's The Beast, which is one of my favorite publications that comes out once a year. And I have his summary for each of the players that we've discussed that could potentially come here. So I'll give you that breakdown tomorrow. So each player that we've, like I said, seen as far as mock drafts, I'll go through that with everyone tomorrow. But yes, when it comes to baseball, Link Jarrett is doing a terrific job at FSU, and the fact that he's been able to turn around, like I said, so quickly with so many guys that certainly were not on his team a season ago has been tremendous. And does it hurt my heart when FSU sweeps Florida for the first time since the year 2000? Yes, that does hurt my heart. However, I can acknowledge certainly that in the past, Florida's been really good. A season ago, almost won the national championship, but just lost to LSU. So
also, he abandoned Notre Dame and left us in the
right.
dust.
So Taylor may not be the biggest fan of Link Jarrett. Also in baseball, the Jumbo Shrimp won yesterday in their matinee 2-1 against Charlotte. They are back at it tonight, and it is, Taylor, a Coors Light Thirsty Thursday. First pitch, 7:05. So you know people are going to be excited for that. Speaking of FSU, the Noles are 27-5 on the season. They play host to Miami, so another rivalry. Had Florida in town on Tuesday, and now have Miami in town. Three-game series. That starts tonight. Usually they start on Fridays, but that one starts tonight at 7 p.m., so Noles fans, you can lock into that. Florida plays host to South Carolina with first pitch tomorrow night at 6:30. I'll be there on Saturday for the 4 o'clock game. Hopefully Florida can win. And then last night, UNF lost to Wofford 10-4. I had a client meeting this morning, and I saw Wofford's bus behind where the restaurant was. Yeah. So I was like, oh, well, I know where Wofford stayed last night after they beat UNF. And then UNF plays host to Lipscomb this weekend starting tomorrow night, 6 o'clock. And JU at Austin Peay, That is also tomorrow night. That one begins at 7 o'clock. So there is your there's your baseball local sports updates. And that's basically going to do it for us, ladies. We will, of course, keep you apprised on the station of Masters updates all day long. For RJ Saunders, for Taylor Dahl, for Mia O'Brien, I'm Lauren Brooks. Keep it right here on 1010XL 92.5 FM for XL Primetime. These heels are made for talking. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
Yeah.
Mia here for Window Gang. It's spring and time to give your home or business a refresh. Window Gang's exterior cleaning services will remove stubborn stains, restore windows to a